Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, everybody. Hope we're all doing well. Happy Friday, everybody. Welcome to the stream. Yes, I've got the hoodie back on. I'll be on for a little bit. Let's start the warm up. It's a bit chilly this morning, but I hope everybody is well on this Friday morning / Thursday afternoon, or if you're in Europe, Thursday night, late Thursday night. Hopefully everyone's well. We're going to do another GA fly today. We've done this route, similar to this route before. But I thought, you know, it's been a long time. Let's go and check it out. And let's go and do it in an amazing aircraft, which is the WB Sim Cessna 172. And do some more GA flying. So hopefully you guys have had an awesome week. It's getting close to the weekend. And hopefully get some simming in this weekend. So it should be fun. So... who's in the chat? Mr. TP, feel free to drop some flight plan suggestions in the Discord. Absolutely. How are you, Mr. TP? Hope you're doing well. Good afternoon to you, my friend, or evening. Chicago Skyhawk, welcome. Hope you're doing well. Carolee, welcome to the stream. Have a great stream and flight. Really great review today. Early bed for me tonight. Nice one. Thank you very much for checking out the update. I've wanted to do some updates on some realware. High fidelity airliners. It's been a while since I checked in on those, so I thought I'd make a quick video about it. Hey, Captain Fozzy, what's going on? Welcome to the stream. Mr. Brett Plays, early one today. Yeah, it's an early one because if I start them a little bit later, it's just a massive day and I'm pushing and trying to get a video out tonight at like midnight. So, and I can start them a little bit earlier while Junior's on holidays, which changes next week. So, I believe you're probably streaming this morning as well. Bio, what's going on? Captain Rays, what's going on? Mr. Kevin, I'm all the way from Pennsylvania. How are you, legend? Welcome to the stream. Dusty, we're always on the West USA server, my friends. I can't kick the bot on until the stream has started. It's just the way the software works. Tricky says, evening, people. Hey, Tricky. Binna, what's going on? Welcome to the stream. Mr. Joseph Jolly is here. How are you, legend? Oh, welcome to the stream. And Mr. Michael from Canberra, hope you well, mate. Hopefully the trip went well. William, what's going on? Welcome to the stream. And Matt, what's going on? Dropping some hypes in the chat. Appreciate that. And I'm not even at that section yet, but Bio's dropped a thing. Thanks for all. Bio says, thanks for all you do. I love the videos and the stream. I wish I could fly with you guys today, but I have my family over, so I'm just stopping to say hi. Bio, thank you very much. I really appreciate doing that, and thank you very much for dropping. There we go. Thank you very much for dropping that in. I appreciate it. That means heaps. So Thanks, legend. There we go. Look at that. Cessna on top of Cessna. It doesn't get much better than that. Does not get much better than that. Cessna on top of Cessna. Thank you, Bio. Appreciate it, mate. We'll be streaming. We'll be streaming soon again, so you'll be able to come and join us, mate. Appreciate it. Where Mrs. TP's here as well. She says, hello, Oz Flight Sim, everyone in chat. Hello, Mrs. TP and the TP family. What's going on? Parapilot says, good morning, Shane. How are you, mate? Hope you're doing well, legend. Welcome to the stream. Who else is loitering about? It's all love. Thank you very much. We love the love. There's no sounds. Oh, I stuffed it. I stuffed it as always. There we go. Let's see if we can do a replay. Yeah, Friday and Saturday off.
Thanks for all you do. Love the videos and the streams. Wish I could fly with you guys today, but have family over, so just stopping by to say hi.
Thank you, mate. Appreciate it. Yeah, Fridays and Saturday. I need to work out something because I had the same conversation with Mrs. Oz. She says, I don't have a day off. And I said, no. So we need to sort that out. We're doing this thing 7 days a week. So, all right. I think I skipped down the list if I missed anybody. Like, and Maddie, what's going on? Zach, what's going on? Welcome to the stream. Willie and Richard is here. How are you, gentlemen? Welcome to the stream. Mr. Tony F. Hey, Tony, what's going on? Oh, and Tony's just done a gifted membership, as he has too. I'll catch up to that in a second. Brian, good morning, good evening, good afternoon. Bulk Hogan, these live streams are an enjoyable break from a study for your ATPL. Well, please don't pick up any bad habits from anything that I do. Mate, enjoy the... I can't say enjoy the study because the ATPL, I haven't done anything like that myself, but I know... studying for any aviation exams, holy dooly, you've just basically got to block everything out and go for it. I know when I did my stuff, it was like blocking out for weeks. We're at David, what's going on? Bob, Johnny, do we know where we're at? We're at Telluride is where we're at, and we're going to go direct to Flagstaff to start off with. Mr. Tony F, thank you very much. Has gifted a membership to Mr. Washington Planable. We're going to get do some stuff in a second. Just give me a sec. We're going to jump on the next screen. We'll just do some more. I think we've got anybody, everybody. Oh, I can't speak. Hope you guys have a great flight. Thank you, Bio. I appreciate it, mate. Thank you very much. What's going on, Conti? Aren't you normally streaming yourself, my friend? Let me fix up the leaderboard here, because we have to do this manually, because Twitch won't... because YouTube's not like Twitch. Doesn't do all the cool stuff. I gotta manually do this. Taking a day off. Nice. I was just saying to that I just had literally had a bit conversation with Mrs. Oz before she walked out the door. Saying that I need to have a day off every now and then. Cool. Let's do this. See if it's going to work this morning. See if it's going to work. Tony F, thank you very much, my friend. I appreciate it. Thank you very much for gifting it. You're the best. Never, never keep you down. You're the best. Oh, crowded kid. There we go. Getting banned, copyright strikes in multiple countries on that one. You got it. Absolutely. Thank you very much for gifting membership to a Washington Plane Legends. Hey, Liftoff, what's going on? All right, let's do this flight today. I'm not sure what's going on with the flight plan, the P&L, because it's Microsoft's doing its thing where it's just going jumbo. So I've had to manually pop it in again. So if you guys are having that, I'm having the same problem as well. We are going to take off runway 12, I believe. The weather over at Sedona, every time, I tell you what, every time I do a GA flight, it's just blowing a gale. It's 36 degrees. The wind is 12, gusting to 23. So not only is it going to be bumpy, it's going to be windy as all. So yeah, this is going to be great fun. But thank you very much, gentlemen. I appreciate the support bio. I need to pin you up to the top there because I didn't do that. There we go. All right. Let's see if I remember how to fly a Cessna, especially the WB Sims. Let's do some fuel. We're going to do 65% in the tanks, we'll do. And we got to adjust the sounds for this guy here. Just some cockpit sounds. 50 should do it. Cool. Beacon light can go on. Nav lights can go on. And we might need to do a sound check for me a little bit later once we get some engines started. That'd be appreciated. Brett's there. Get my throttle tensions all good to go. Cool. Alright. What are we doing? Clear on the left. Clear on the right. Parking brakes on. Fuel is on. And we're set to... go set to both tanks. There we go. Then we won't have to worry about too much there. Come on, girl. There she goes. Oh, mate, I tell you what. And the sound set that you can get for this over at Orbex. I can't remember. I have been in the mental block. Can't remember the gentleman's name. It just makes such a difference. This is one of the best combinations in flight sim going around, in my opinion. WB Sims plus... what's the sound set? Cessna down set. Orbex. I can't remember the gentleman's name, but he's a legend. Yeah, the Burris sound set. Yeah, the Burris set works awesome. Yeah, it's a great partnership. It's lovely, but I'd say, Burris, you need to make some more stuff, because your stuff's good. Alternator can go on. Beto heat's going to go on. Fuel. Oh, we didn't start that with the fuel pump. No wonder she was a bit nancy. But anyways, we're going to let things warm up. Preset RPM just a smidgen. And we'll just lean her out a little bit there. Avionics can go on. Orbex is just flight. Well, you can pick it up at just flight, so. As well. Let's check the meter. The meter is... helipascals. I don't want helipascals. We are 1017. It's giving me 1018, so we're actually on 1017. There we go. Let's arrow in. Go up 7.5. I don't even know what direction I'm going to be flying. Pretty pastels. Yeah, they taste great, don't they? Absolutely they do. What plans all are bugged in. And this guy on the standby. And while we're waiting for all the T's and P's, engine pressure is good. Temps are starting to come up. Fuel pressure is good there. Fuel flow is good. EGT temperatures are good. So all the T's and P's are green. Amps are good. And we're going to do a quick taxi over. The runway, and then we'll do a run up down there, shall we, once everything's all warmed up. What tool do I use for traffic liftoff? This is all generated. This is community traffic. This is all generated by the app called Love. I know it's corny, isn't it? But yes, this is all community generated. Right.
Oh, we've got a caribou over there. Best love. Yes, absolutely. Looks like great flight. Yes. I've done this sort of area before, Conti, a couple of times, but nothing for a little bit, so. And we do have a sunset. So we should have some awesome lighting across the Monument Valley when we get there. Brakes are checked out okay. Hey, Don, what's going on? There we go. Loving the livery. How's the sound? She's sounding a little bit, I think on the outside, she's a little bit too loud. Yeah, might need just to adjust those sounds quickly by a couple of notches. Because once we actually get some RPM up, she's going to be pretty noisy. Oh, we got a turbo arrow. Nice one. So hopefully everybody's week's been well since we last saw you on a Wednesday, which was a day and a half ago, pretty much. It's going to be a big week in the world of Microsoft Flight Simulator next week. Oh, holy dooly, it's going to be a big week. Guys, we'll just have to wait and see. It's going to be massive. Very much excited looking for the week ahead. Come on, girl. She's a bit of a struggle with the high altitude and getting the engine to her the way that I want it to. No, Michael. No, they don't. ATA is coming out with their Warrior next. I have no idea. Comanche? Nah. Don't ask, and I'm gonna tell you. You just have to watch the news video tonight, and you'll get a bit of a hint. I'm not saying any more. I'm just teasing. Just teasing. I'm a bit of a flight sim tease. Question, can we fly from Mandalore to... I have no... Obviously, I don't know that area very, very well. So you're welcome to put it in our Discord, a flight plan request, and I can have a look at it. The PMDG 777. Jeez, you guys are just lynching. Lynching for hooping. Yeah, the actual full release of Microsoft Flight Simulator. Hopefully the 757's coming soon. The guys over at Bluebird basically said that the 757 is probably, they're aiming to get it out before the end of the year, but it's probably going to switch over to early next year. So if they're already saying early next year, you always add 30% onto that. So I'm looking at like mid. New car, boat, dream on. I'm a professional YouTuber. There's none of that. You just add 30% onto what the devs are thinking. That's generally when a project will come out. So if they're saying a month, say 3 months. If they're saying a year, it's going to take a lot longer. So, Cessna Sim, we're at Telluride. You can put an exclamation mark flight plan in the chat and it'll pop up. But thank you for Tony for the gifted membership and also Bio for the Canadian super chat. Appreciate it. Itchy nose. At some point, we will probably be whacking the autopilot on, and I've got to do a brekkie break. a coffee break sometime through the stream. I'm not sure when. Have we got like a run-up area here? We don't. I guess it's going to be here. Let's do a run-up right in front of the fence in this building here. You know, you're not meant to. Actually, there was a spot over there I could do it. You're not meant to. This is like what you're not meant to do, but anyways. Sort of want to do it into the wind. Alright. I don't know how to do run-ups for Cessnas because I've never flown one, but I know how to do a run-ups for planes, so we'll see how we go. Yeah? I didn't have any taxi lights on. Holy dooly. Alright, let's check. T's and P's are good. Temps are good. Pressure's up. Vacuum's good. Okay, that's all good to go. We're on all tanks. Normally we'd flip to the fullest tank now, but we're on all tanks, so that's fine. Make sure the brakes are holding, and they are. I need to do this with this aircraft because they actually simulate carbon on the pistons, I believe, or the mags plane up too, so. Oops. Zooming in when 170. Off. All good. I wish she's gonna idle it. Yep. I don't know what the idling's meant to be for this thing. I don't know my RPMs for this aircraft is my problem. Caribou's awesome in VR. I tell you what, I haven't done a bunch of VR for a long time, so... Unfortunately. Alrighty, I think we're good to go. The only way Tony flies... See, you mean, Tony, I need to talk to you as much as possible when we're streaming. Because you're in VR, so you have to keep taking your headset off. It's like, don't tell me you're in VR, because I'll start talking to you. Alright, I'll tell you off. Oh, look at that. Everyone's behaving themselves this morning. Very cool. I put my brakes on. Right. All your instruments in the WB in my... hey, Marcus, what's going on? The dark? That's interesting. I have no idea why they'd be dark, other than obviously I know that you know how to turn on the right correct switches for a Cessna, so I don't know. Probably what you need to do maybe is just go and check to make sure the barrow's in and arm the barrow. That's the only thing I could think of why it would be doing it. What's going on, Cameron? Morning, mate. Hope you're doing well. Alrighty. Strobe's going on. Taxi lights going off. Landing lights can go on. That's all good. We're going to switch that to alt 47. And we're displaying 48 on here. Interesting. Flaps are down. Need to do some more flying in other countries. What's going on, Jess? Clear on the left. No incoming traffic. Clear on the right. Should be 1-2. Well, 21. That's what I was trying to get to. 21, 1-2. What runway is this thing giving me? Oh, 21. Yeah, that's right. Line up, Oz Flight Simmer. Right, we're going to use all available runway. I need to turn those sounds down even more. It's going to take a while to get the speed since we're high altitude. Oh, we've got speed wobbles. That's because I didn't fly this thing for a crosswind. Didn't use any aileron then, because I was being lazy. There we go. I'll turn the sounds down in a sec. Bursts. Voice 7 and music 4. Flaps going up. She's a handful to fly with the wind. Clear on the right. Left. Those flaps didn't go up. With the wind. Hey PW, what's going on? I got my hands full at the moment. Are you still on those same noise numbers for me, Brett, that we're in the air? Might be me that needs to turn my headset down, probably. There we go, get some altitude. Just seen there's a Just Fly F28 preview tonight. God damn it! Secret's gone. God damn it. Some altitude here. Just going to drop those sounds down just a smidgen because they're a bit loud for me. It's always the one that ruins it. I said I can't tell you. There's already a couple of content creators are already cementing their stakes in the YouTube time. by doing premieres and stuff already, so. So going to Flagstaff, I'm struggling to get some engine power. Just give me a sec here. Now we're better. Is it going to be Comanche news in the update? There's nothing new when it comes to the Comanche. The Comanche's pretty much been built. They're just doing the final touches to it, so. And he's making the video, so that'll take him a while. I don't think you'll see the Comanche out for maybe at least a month. Yeah, there is good sales with the honeycomb at the moment. Yeah, absolutely. Especially in Europe, there is. Everyone's got them for a discounted price. It'd be interesting if we actually even get to Monument Valley with this weather tonight. We are struggling on the altitude. And the wind, of course. There's Flagstaff up ahead on the left-hand side. Live weather on. Affirmative, yeah. Yep, got the live weather on. We're getting some mechanical turbulence from the canyon here. Because we're a bit close, now we're sinking. Yeah, there's no way we could be doing... Holy dolly! I'd be shitting myself right now. This thing is loud. Or maybe I'm not used to using my headsets again. Yeah, bath bags, yeah. We just need to get some altitude so we're not getting rocked around by these canyons. So we got sucked in the canyon before, and now we're getting lifted. Monument's still standing in the wind. Yeah, it's gusting up to 23 knots. And I always never check the wind. Like, well, when I did the flight plan like last night, it was all right, but now it's come out windy, so. Not even bothering using rudder at this stage because she's all over the shop. It's 7.5. This is going to be a bit of a workout. I was going to do a touch and go at Flagstaff, but I don't think I'm bothered. I think I'm going to do an overfly. Still yesterday, still Thursday. I don't think I'm going to land because it's taken me so much to gain this altitude. This Flagstaff's over there somewhere, I think, from memory. Feels great in VR. Haven't had a chance to look at the views yet this morning. Can't even speak, it's too early. I've got another. No, there's 8.5 there. See if we can get the autopilot to hold for us. Holy dooly. That was interesting. See if the autopilot's able to do its job when it's been a little bit windy. Let's see how we go. Hey, Nox, what's going on, Storm? Welcome. I proposed to my wife in Monument Valley. Oh, there you go. Nice. Seems like a beautiful place. Never been there in real life. Now we're getting away from the canyons there. It seems to be calming down a little bit. But it's going to take 3 minutes to do 1.6. Holy dooly. Ground speed's still 124 though, so that's interesting. No, it doesn't have yaw dampener. No, it's just going to be moving around all over the place. There's a very beautiful hotel you can stay where you get the perfect views at Monument Valley. Nice. I should go one day if I ever get over that way again. Do I use the camping pack? Negative, sir. No, I don't have the camping pack from the guys at Parallel 42. Not that I don't think it's a bad product, it's just something that I, you know, can't see myself just unpacking the tent for 3 minutes. As usual, yeah, mate, this is the life of luxury. The avionics suite on this would be worth more than what the plane's probably, so. There we go. Flagstaff's just loading in. We do have good performance in the sim today though, so that's one good news. It's good for those coffee breaks. What, the yaw dampener or the autopilot? The autopilot's good for coffee breaks. How far are we from the valley? Just give me 2 seconds because I'm just going to get on to our next heading. And hopefully I didn't put us going straight into the mountain. Like an idiot. Oh, it actually loaded this time. It did. Right, that's not going to work. That's not going to work. What we might do is we're going to have to fly around. I'm going to fly around to the right side of it. It's going to be too high for our little Cessna to handle. I live in Utah since 1986 and then been down to Monument Valley. How far away, like, I'd have to look at a map because my geography on the US is not the best when it comes to the state names. Like, Utah is just north of it, isn't it? Or is it in the same... Don't tell me it's in the same bloody state. Hey, Jay, what's going on? Oh, the camping pack's good for coffee. Ah, right. So just going to go a detour around these mountains there, because there's no way we're going to get ourselves into that trouble. And we will... once we get to... Hilo Golf Charlie November, we'll have a bit of a quick stop. That Flagstaff's even got a golf course, holy dooly. I Around, okay, cool. Theory here is on off head, basically. Oh, there we go. The bod's doing what it should be doing. Putting power lines where the gaps are, where the power lines should be. Nice. It's about 7 hours from where you are, Jess. Ah, okay. Stefan, what's going on? Welcome. Mr. Aviator's in the 172s at 10,000 feet. How much is going to cost? I have no idea, Willie. I have no idea. I'm assuming probably around about the same price as the 146 professional, but don't quote me because I actually have no idea. Captain Ray, I'm using the Yoke, and I'm using the Virtual Flow V3 Vernios, and at the moment I'm still using the Turtle Beach rudder pedals. Actually, I've been using them for a couple of months. I'm still using them, so. My plane over there, cool. Okay, turn over. Hear a lot of holy doolies? Yeah, it's because she's windy. He is windy. Okay, hopefully that gets us on course. But now we're going to be beating into a bit of a crosswind here, so it's going to get quite bumpy. What's going on, Kevin? Looking forward to the Beyond ATC later on this year. Yeah, it looks interesting. I'll definitely be checking it out. I'm interested to see what it's going to be like. So, and I'm interested from a real pilot's point of view, but I'm also interested from how natural is it going to sound. So, do I get the same vibes when I'm talking on the radio in real life? That's what I'm looking for. So. Really good turnout for the stream. Yeah, we got heaps of people for a Friday morning, which is interesting. I did do a bit of an invite to our friends over at the Symphonatic channel to see if they wanted to come and join us. So if you are on the Symphonatic channel, you're one of the Sim fans over there, oh, welcome, because Darren's out on having holidays at the moment, so not able to do his multiplayer stream. So we've said, hey, come and join us. The turbines on departure, yeah, if it was me, I wouldn't be flying in real life in this weather. Too windy. Just got to pick my routes through here while we get through this little section here. And then after that, we should be right for altitude. All over the shop. Do I use Volanta? No. Like, I've recently thought about using it again, but then I just can't be bothered because it's something else that I've got to turn on, and it doesn't really do much for me other than I can track my flights and then I can show everybody else what flights I'm doing. Other than that, I don't really have a need for it. I think we can stay on this heading. I was going to fly through the gap here because the altitude's less, but I think we might be all right. Beyond ATC looks great and interesting, but yet again, Xbox users are left behind. Yeah, well, that's the problem, TP, with the Xbox technology and third-party developers and how it gets introduced. They can't just make the Xbox platforms locked down. There's only certain things that you can do with it, so the only way to get around to that is moving to PC. I know it's, you know, is what it is. But yeah, you're not going to get away from that. It's always going to be that when it comes to Xbox and PC. You're going to be limited of what add-ons are going to be there. So it is absolutely heartbreaking, but it is, that's what it is. Hopefully when they do the freeware scenery gateway, that might change some bits and pieces so you guys get access to some free scenery mods and stuff like that. We'll see how we go. No, I don't think it was a money grab. Well, obviously, yeah, they're a business. They're going to be making profit from it. But I think it's great that they've actually done it on Xbox. It's brought so many people accessible to virtual aviation. But the platform obviously is limited. We're about to stall. It is the WB Sims Cessna 172 with the Boris sound pack, but you can pick those up over at Just Float Hikara. Just Float support the channel by doing a bunch of giveaways and stuff like that when we do our big stream, so I appreciate their support. They're great for the community here, and they've been very, very generous and given probably thousands of dollars of stuff to you guys for the community. So hopefully we can do the same thing down the line with the F-28 and some of their other stuff. So they said they'll have it on Xbox, but not for a while. Yeah, I guess it's easy for them to develop on a PC platform and then figure out how to get it onto the Xbox after that. Hey, Impendent Joker, what's going on? All right, I need to change his angle of attack. The Green and Blue Productions, thank you very much for the subscription. Holy dooly, I've got some trim in this thing. Autopilot's just not trimming the plane properly. Nah. The autopilot's not trimming the plane properly. I'm just gonna have to manually hand fly it for a bit. Really want the Just Float Tomahawk Pura of FS 2020. The Hawk is amazing. It's a great aircraft. And for me, I don't really fly jets, but I love it. I think it's great. But just using the Steam Gauge version? Absolutely. I'm a Steam Gauge guy. I'm sorry, guys. We're not getting much views of the awesome scenery. It's because I've actually got to fly this thing today. No worries, Tony. Cheers, mate, and thank you very much for the gifted membership, mate. Appreciate that. Let's see Tony out the door today. You're the best. That's Tony. Join April 7th. And they gifted that membership tally. sorry, the Tomahawk. I'm thinking you. I'm reading Tomahawk and you're saying the Hawk. Yeah, hopefully the Tomahawk will be out later this year. They've had a delay. They actually said there's a delay with it that is outside their control. I think it may be a third-party dev that's developing it. Yeah, I gotcha. This thing can fly the heading for me. I'll just do the altitude with the trim and then hopefully we have some success. So we're going to be stalling all over the shop until they can simulate the outside of the cockpit. A deep stall recovery method on the Tomator is not a sale for you. You'll just have to wait independent joke until it's come out to see what they've been able to do with it, I guess. But I've used their Tomahawk in X-Plane. It was absolutely fantastic. It was a great product. I used it in Prepared as well. It was pretty good in Prepared for the limitations of Prepared. Maybe just wait and see Impending Joker, because Just Flight are very innovative. They're pushing the boundaries on stuff, and you guys are probably going to see that when the Fokker is released. They are going great guns in some of the stuff, so maybe just wait and see what they can do. Until it's released, we've got no idea, I guess. But if it's possible, they're the guys that will do it. Well, it won't give the correct reading. Got 33.6 hours in this WB Sims mock-up. But I don't know if the Hobbs... Actually, I've still got my... probably don't need my landing lights, considering everybody's name tags. But I don't know if it's... when I've done... what am I talking about? I can't even speak this morning. Probably need a coffee. When I've done updates to the model, I don't know if it wipes out the Hobbs time. So Independent Joe brings on great competition, that's for sure. Now, I think we're going to see some GA stuff that's actually going to blow people's minds, and it's not just going to be from A2A either. It's got some really cool stuff. Keep an eye out for what FS Reborn is doing, which is absolutely crazy stuff. So this is cool. We're getting devs that are really bringing on the good stuff now. Now the sim's been out for a couple of years. They're getting to play around with it. They can do some cool stuff, and we get to sit back as being members of the community and consumers and people that buy their products. We get to show our appreciation and show the developers what we think is a great product by getting our wallets out. So, but the FS Reborn stuff, I haven't had access to it, but what I've seen and what I've heard from people, the stuff's going to be absolutely amazing with the stuff that they're doing on the 500. So. Have to wait and see. Gotta wait for him to release first. It's no good unless it's released. I was gonna try to do this semi-realistic and actually fly this morning proper navs and actually record everything down, and I was actually gonna write it up on a flight plan and manually, but then I was like, nah, it's too early for that. In 2020, yeah. You can see that point. No, you don't need to. Everybody's good to have their point, but I guess we've got to wait until it's released, I guess. The thing is, there's been many of times where promo videos and hype videos obviously hype the product up, and then they're not as good. That being said, I obviously bought pretty much all of A2A products, and I'm pretty confident what Scott says it's gonna do. So, what's that, Nelson? What's going on, my legend? I hope you're doing well. Here we go, Mr. Harry's here, dropping some orange whips into the chat. I'm not gonna bother doing the orange whips though. I'm gonna leave that to Mr. Sim Fanatic. But thank you very much for jumping in, seeing some Sim fans in there as we do some flying today. And no, I don't wear sunny glasses when I'm flying, though. Oh, I do in real life, but not in the sim. Alright, we're going to try to resume at navigation, put it onto nav. And I'm going to keep pushing this back over. Let's see if we can grab it. Oh, who's that bouncing around? It'd be hard to try to fly formation in this weather. Extremely hard. Keep looking there for a clock. Temperatures are good, pressures are good, fuel is balanced. Amps good, vacuum is good, fuel flow is good. Okay, EGT temperatures, we're fine. Engine's nice and cool. Not too cold, not too hot. The Cessna 172 is good in real life. Many students I know who transition from 150 or 152 or 172 find it hard to adjust, but after adjusting, they don't want to go back to flying at 150, 152 again. Ah. And of course, they'd have some shoulder room as well, I guess. Is Beyond ATC, yeah, Independent and Joker. We were speaking about that before. I think I'm looking forward to it. I hope it feels natural. 172 is okay, but it's a bit boring. Well, the reason why we're flying the 172 is because it's got the WB Sims. Make it a bit more realistic in the Boris sound pack. That's why I like flying it, because it's more realistic. If I had something else to fly that caters for this sort of stuff, I would fly it, but there's nothing there. So and we flew the Just Flight Arrow the other day, so scenery looks amazing. The Bulk Hogan. Oh, thank you, mate, appreciate it. We tried to pick a scenic route for today. Sorry about the window. We may do... What are we doing for time today? I I might, oh, then I've got mountains in the road. What was going on there? But I can say that the twin engine, like the Baron, is more fun. Yeah, Black Square have done awesome with the Baron and the Bonanza. Done great job. It's going to take us a little bit longer to get here then. It's meant to only be like an hour and 50 minute flight, but with the weather, I don't think it's going to be an hour and 50 minute flight. And I just saw someone slewing. Again, I don't think Bio's here, but Bio, thank you very much for the $10 super chat, and also Tony for gifting the membership. I think both of those gents have actually left the chat. But appreciate the support, guys, and also to Just Flight for supporting the streams as always. Have I tried the Carinata Cessna? I've got a bunch of Carinata products. I haven't done that 182. RG for the retractable gear. I haven't checked that one out, only because I can't afford to purchase every plane that's in the sim, unfortunately. And I've got a bunch of different Cessnas already in Carinato products, so I gave this one a bit of a miss, even though it did look quite good and I was looking forward to it, but no. Thank you to everybody that checked out our video we dropped last night too. If you checked it out and then dropped a comment in it, I appreciate it. It helps out a lot when you guys are able to do that. So you have the Carinato Arrow, it's pretty good. Wait for the Carinato sale. But do they actually have many sales these days, since they're just putting stuff in the marketplace? Not as much as they used to. When they had Carinato and then they had the sister company, what was the sister company now? They were basically releasing a product pretty much every second week in prepared days. They used to do quite a lot of sales back then. Had a real one fly over the house the other day. Alabeo, that's what it was. Yeah, sister company. They're a great mid-tier aircraft. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. They fill the spot for people that just want to get up and go flying and enjoying the sim. Absolutely. There is a spot for the Carinato products. And, you know, they've been hassled for many years for making great-looking planes, but not high-fidelity aircraft. But that's the price point that they're going for. Like, when the Comanche comes out, the Comanche won't be cheap. Like A2A, when they release, they put their price tag accordingly to where the aircraft's at. So I think people will see the price tag on that comes out, unless Scott does something different. But in the past, they've been quite expensive. Yeah, Carinato have improved. Yeah, I would agree with you there, Conti. Conti's been smashing the 182RG around in on his streams. Such a treat, yeah. Did you ever get to jump in a 182RG in real life? put just a 182. Monty's flown a bunch of stuff. Yeah, you've got a few hours in RJ. I thought you might. Mother and son flight simulator, flew one a couple of times. Nice. What's going on here? Oh no, just the angle there. I thought, holy dooly, we're not looking good here with the angle of attack, but it's not too bad. Thanks very much for everybody coming out and joining us on the flight. We've got a few of you guys here. A few from Sims stream and also from our viewers, so it's cool to see for a Friday morning, considering we haven't been doing Friday morning flights, so. Hey, Silver Killer, what's going on? Welcome to the stream, hope you're doing well, my friends. Server on the West USA server. We should say we're on the Vomit server. Holy dooly, we're bouncing around. Thursday evening for you guys, yeah. Depending which part of the world. It's like probably close to midnight in the UK, Europe, UK time. Be close to midnight, UK time. Let me do that. Yes, midnight in UK, US, it's all over the place because you guys have got like 4,000 time zones. Afternoon to evening. Oh, there we go. Almost 4 p.m. Yeah. Well, I sort of started it a little bit early, only because I've got to get into some making a video, which will take me all day. It's 1 a.m. where Geo is. Yeah. Kevin says you have several time zones there in Oz. We do. Yeah, we've got a couple. You know, once we get past Adelaide, we don't worry about the rest. We don't worry about the rest of the time zones. We get to Adelaide, we stop there. We don't worry about the rest. Oh, I'm going to wait for all our Western Australian friends to jump in and go, what? Hey Michael, what's going on? Welcome to the stream. You have friends in Perth? There you go. WA is separate country. Well, that's what they say. It's so far away and there's not much in between. Wait till Beto hears this. Oh, he's nothing he hasn't heard before. Nothing that he hasn't heard before. Merch idea, holy dooly. Nah. I really can't be bothered with merch, Brett. I really can't be bothered. For the time and effort you put into it, there's the return's not there. It's a nice to have, but it's not a necessity. I've been watching, hey Kevin, I've been watching a YouTube channel on the Australian road trains. Oh, nice. Yeah, we've got a bit of, there's a bit of stuff out there on that sort of stuff. We've still got 7.4 nautical miles to go. Let's see if we can start seeing this airport, which I believe it's probably this thing over here. 5:02. I'm not sure what times the sunset go down and around this way. Maybe we might get some nice colours of Monument Valley by the time we get there. It is bumpy, yeah. Actually, I'll see if I can get the meter for Kilo Golf Charlie November. So I didn't bother getting the meter at Flagstaff. Yeah. Interesting. So VFR conditions, it's still 32.2 degrees. We've got winds at 15, gusting to 29 at 240. Visibility is more than 10 nautical miles. And the QNH is 1020. Runway 3. Did the flight last year with the Valley? Yeah, we've flown here before. Not this exactly route, but it's been a while. I thought, oh, let's go and do some GA flying today. Can't believe that the PA with the Oakman aircraft registration exists. Is that a default with the package or is that something from Flight Sim TR? I can't remember. It is windy, absolutely. Yeah, it's crazy. But it actually exists in real life. Been flying the Vision Jet? Yeah, I don't know. I was disappointed when the Vision Jet come out. I know they've done some updates in it, but I haven't really gone back to it. Double Ender is fun. I want to pick it up, Kat. I want to pick the Double Ender up. I think that'd be a lot of fun. Interesting, I was reading the history about the Double Ender. The last known flight they know about was in 2015, and there was one ever built because it was a prototype. So it's quite an interesting history of the Double Ender. Do I have my fuel pumps on landing lights? Yeah. I've kept my fuel pump on the whole time because she's bumpy as. I hope so, Kat. Hopefully we it doesn't take too long to get there. And if you guys are enjoying the stream still, take a notch of flaps. Doesn't want us to turn in. Oh, this is going to be interesting. still applying pressure on the yokes. I'm still trimming. West USA, yeah. Did I land on the wrong runway? I did do. I wasn't watching what I was doing. I meant to be landing on runway 3. Coming the opposite end. Oh, no. Hang on. Need to check my Mido report. Oh, no. Runway 12 is what I was meant to be going. I read it right, but I was saying the opposite runway. Holy dolly. I'm relieved about that. Gonna ease the throttle out on this. Don't care if we use a lot of runway up. Oh man. Far out, that was bad. I ballooned it and then I touched the front. That was a front wheel landing. Then I bounced it. Oh my god, that was bad. That was all bad. That was all bad. You'd be sitting there, if you're sitting at the hangars and you watch me land, you'd be like, yeah. That's what happens. It does happen when you see someone in bad landing. Everyone's critiquing it. Captain critiques everywhere at the airport. Captain critiques everywhere at the airport. That's what you do. Oh, that's a bad one. Holy dooly, look at that guy. Blame the winds. Oh, it was quite windy, yeah. Judge not, you be the judge, yeah. But it's what happens, doesn't that, Conti? That's what happens. People are there sitting there and they're watching. I've done it myself. Easy for armchair pilots to judge a landing and then go up and butcher it themselves. Absolutely. Yep. I remember, Conti, a little while back I had to go and get a circuit check. And when I had the instructor in the circuit check, I haven't flown for a bit. My landings, I was so surprised, right? They were awesome. He's like, nah, we only need to do 2 laps because your landings are great. I was like, ah, these are awesome. He hopped out of the plane, next one, smash. I wasn't smashed, but it wasn't a great landing. So, you know, and the conditions were exactly the same. You can be fine, and then the next minute you have a bad one. Or not so great one. Probably smash is not the term I want to use. It wasn't a smash, but you get the drift. Save my best landings when you have an instructor doing a check on you. You do. You lose the muscle memory very, very quickly. Yep. When I right-click to look around the cockpit, my peripherals don't work until I stop looking around. That's very interesting. I'm not sure what the go is with that. I say Conti knows about it. There we go. Great that we have awesome people in the community that are willing to help out others, so. Yeah, so you lose the muscle memory, but you also lose the little bit of confidence too. Because you haven't done it for a while, you haven't stretched your limits for a bit. So that happens too. You just got to be consistent as much as you can. And unfortunately, this year has probably done the most, the least amount of flying due to cancellations, maybe not well and stuff like that, so it's a bit of a shame. I'm still flying, but not as much as I would like. This must be, I've got a funny feeling that this must be like a third party freeware I've downloaded. But the runway markings are a bit different than what you would normally see. Hey Dion, what's going on? Welcome to the stream. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to set the autopilot up on it, this one, and I've got to go and check on Junior and also see if we can get some toast for brekkie or something. Thanks everybody for coming out, I appreciate it. And thank you very much for all your support, guys. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. Hey Blair, yeah, we were talking about it before. Yeah. Yeah, time for some coffee. Where's the best musty places? It depends. Oz is such a diversified place. It depends on what stuff you want to see. It's a massive country. It depends if you want to see the bush or you want to see the coast or the cities. Yokes make a massive difference, Ozmad. Really puts the immersion into the flying. I bet most of us have seen it, but I'm excited about it, but don't want to avoid overloading the hopes of unrealistic levels, eh? Yeah. I hear ya. We Love VFI has a Region 2 update ready. Oh, does it? Have they just done an update? Hey, that guy, what's going on? Yep, 1 hour ago. Cool, thank you, Willie. I'll, if someone wants to grab it and put in the development update in the Discord, that'd be much appreciated. If not, that's all good. Where are we going to now? Okay, so we need to go to heading 12. Say I'm going the opposite direction. Working on a home on the East Coast, are trying to finish to sell it. Oh, okay. Holy dooly. Jesus. What direction am I meant to be flying here? I'm getting myself lost. Thanks, Willie. Appreciate it. Do you still use the headphone simulations? No. How do you mean, do you still use? I don't think I've ever used it. Sorry guys, sometimes it's a little bit harder in the chat to talk when there's so much wind around in this thing. Sort of getting stable now. Mostly heat turbulence. Actually, it's 32. Actually, we checked. It is 32.2 degrees, and also it's winds. It's the winds as well. So it's 15 gusting to 29. So it's windy and it's hot. So we got the best of both worlds. Yeah, oh boy, yeah. It's been interesting. I thought I'd be able to just cruise, put the autopilot on, and chat to you guys and have awesome scenery, but I've pretty much had the hand flight the whole way. And we've been sitting in the cockpit pretty much for the whole stream. 91 Fahrenheit, if you say so. I've got it set to degrees Celsius, obviously. Go and see if I can get something to eat quickly. Been using the updated map enhancer. Have I missed that? Is there a map enhancer? A mod. Blair, we do have a shared cockpit. There's a third-party app called Third Control. Your Controls. So, it is available. It's free. It does work. I could do share controls with someone right now. But it's only available for PC users, though. Yeah, Your Controls. Just go and search it, and it's free to download. Works quite well. They have a list of what aircraft that it works in, but it works more, a lot more aircraft than what that list actually says, so. As we fly over the canyon here. And of course, Oz is going to go and try to have something to eat when we're flying over one of the best parts, but anyways. It's very awesome. Yeah, go and check it out. It's Australia? Yeah. Absolutely, it does. No, thank you, too windy. It'll be interesting flying over this canyon, but it's going to get too late. It's 9:21. If I don't do it now, it's too late for breakfast. This. And this is going to get a lot more sharper in 2024. It'll be amazing. Like, it looks good now, but it's going to be getting better. Good news, bad news, bad news. That there is a brief power outage that knocked me out of the stream. Good news at the Honeycomb Alpha controls that just arrived. There we go, Richard. See, it was fate. It was giving you time to pull them out, have a look at them. There you go. Congratulations on the new controls, my friend. Look at, we're getting sucked down now. Look at this. This is crazy. Hey, Colonel, what's going on? I hope you're doing well, my friend. This is crazy stuff. Let's go out for a nice little Sunday flight down to Monument Valley. Holy dolly, it's windy. We're getting pushed down at the moment. Hey, 717, how you doing, my friend? I'd be sitting in here at literally changing my underwear. What's the altitude on the other side, guys? Is the 8.5 going to do it for me or not? Doesn't look like it. Just do 300 on the BS. We won't go nuts. 9 should do it. Okay. Hey, Mr. Two Tone Murphy, what's going on, legend? Hope you're doing well, my friends. A legend is here. Another Twitch legend. We've got a couple of you guys in here today. We're in a really little plane flying in bad weather over canyons. We're basically one prop bayer from our doom, so. I enjoyed your 747 stream the other day, Murph. That was a lot of fun. In the Air Force One liveries. Beautiful livery. Yeah, it's a little similar to the, Mr. What's his name? Aviation 101 Cessna. An intercept? No worries, Don. Alright, guys, I'm gonna duck out for a little bit. I'm just gonna go and cook some toast, check on the kids, and then I'll be back. If we don't survive the crossing here, just scream. Screaming helps, I believe. Right, back soon. We'll be right back. Alrighty. Oh no, the bloody Karate Kid's come in there and stuffed it up again. Probably getting banned in multiple countries again. Reckon we're in Utah now. Hey Daniel, thank you very much for the 5 months. I appreciate the support.
Very relaxing moment.
Thanks, legend. I'm just gonna check where we're getting. Where are we? Cool. All right. I'm just gonna scoff some breakfast down in the background. It's too quiet. Couldn't hear. Yeah, maybe. I just switched it up then, so I need to, I don't know how I got in that playlist. I got to take it out. But Daniel, thank you very much for that 5 months of support. Appreciate it, fella. Waving at my camera. But you wouldn't have been able to see because I got it turned off like an idiot. Where are we? No idea. Captain, you can put in exclamation mark specs into the chat and then they'll all pop up. Dave, I'm having breakfast. I'm trying to eat my breakfast, dude. And you're gonna make me sing? You're a pain in the backside. Very funny man. Very funny man. Hang on, give me a second. Hashtag you're the best. I've got to do it on this screen because I actually don't have it set up for the... I could have done it on the other screen too. It's only a sound mod. But Kraken's been gifted a membership by Dave. Thank you very much for doing that. I appreciate the support. And yes, the hoodie's gone. You're the best. You're the best. Back to eating breakfast. Dave's still cementing himself in the fourth spot. So we got Evil sitting on 21. Mr. Sinfanatic sitting on 11. Mr. Eagle One in third on 10. Big Jacko sitting by himself on 7. Tony Beto, Mr. TPI are sitting in the fifth spot. And we've got Admiral sitting in sixth. And Cameron, Mr. Wounded Warrior, and Tony F in equal seventh spot when we come to the leaderboard. Thank you very much for the gifted memberships. I appreciate it. Thank you, bugger. Just thought I'd play it again, Dave, so it's sitting in your head when you're driving or when you're at work.
singing it all day.
Nice. Everyone, I've got food in my mouth. Hopefully you guys can't hear it. Next runway is dirt. Nice. So once we land here, we're going to be taking off to Navajo Mountain, or whatever it's called over there. We're going to give Paige a bit of a skip. Only when I talk. Okay. That's the runway there, isn't it? Hey, Mark, what's going on? Actually, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. It's going to take me ages to get down there and get back up, so I'm just going to overfly this one. Sorry, guys. And plus, I'm eating breakfast, so. All the bad things that streamers shouldn't do. So we're just going to overfly. It'll literally take us half an hour. Or 20 minutes to descend and then try to get back up to a decent altitude. In the wind, yeah, absolutely. If it wasn't windy, I would have just said, yeah, no worries. Where is it? It's underneath us somewhere. There it is there. No worries, Iron. See you, mate. Thanks very much for hanging around. Appreciate it. Be driven through Paige in Arizona. Was it nice? Nice place. I thought we were about to stall. Because when I increased my altitude again to climb, I didn't adjust the throttle enough, so it's all right. We'll just get the speed up and then we'll continue a slow up to 10.5. Yeah, it has a large damp. Yeah, absolutely. Just over there somewhere, I believe. There's an awesome media creator. Yeah, is that, that's the big one, isn't it, Ashley? Like the big, big, big one. Just watching the angle attack, because the autopilot with the wind seems to be struggling a little bit. Huge, yeah. I've seen it on TV, of course. The television. All right. Excuse me, probably got stuff in my teeth. Is that Paige over there? Might be not. I can't remember. I need to get my bearings. Doing a quick scan. Just subscribe to the first class lounge. I'd appreciate it, Mark. Thank you very much. Did it not pop up? Did the bot not pick it up? Nothing's picked up. As soon as, oh, I appreciate it. Thank you very much for doing that, Mark. Thank you, mate. Yeah. So you'll be able to do a just every month as well. You'll be able to hit the when you hit the button on the YouTube will come up where you'll be able to let me know, and then it will pop up and we can celebrate it. So just got back from my local airport. Witnessed my first rejected takeoff. Was there watching a couple of planes fly over the air show this weekend. What sort of plane was it, Ryan? Done plenty. I've done a bunch of rejected takeoffs before. One that I did myself because I couldn't see a helicopter, so I rejected the takeoff. That was interesting. The other ones were just simulated with instructors. It's not holding altitude. It's full of passengers. Holy dooly. 208. There we go. Alright. We're zooming now. Grollip. Welcome to the stream. Hopefully I said that correctly. I didn't butcher it too much.
Today's exercise is dogfighting. Guns only, no missiles. We do not go below the hard deck of 5,000 feet. Working as a team, you have to shoot me down or else.
Or else what, sir?
Or else I shoot back.
Hey, Geo. There's Paige. That's definitely Paige over there. Once we get to Monument Valley though, guys, we're just not gonna land there. We're gonna have to fly around and have a look at the monuments. Is that what they're called? They're called monuments? I don't know. The rocks. Formations. Nothing serious, but got to see a P-51 and two A-10s so far. Real deals start tomorrow. On the rear, oh, that's right. You're doing the new, you're doing a new job, aren't you? Valley so cool? Yeah, I've been there a bunch of times in the sim. I've shot a lot of B-roll in Monument Valley. It's a nice place. But just look at this. Like, we don't have scenery like this in Oz. Like, we've got this sort of stuff, but we just don't have the rock formations and stuff like this. It's crazy. The Oshkosh air show will start soon. It just feels like we just had Oshkosh. I'm seeing people talk about Oshkosh, but it just feels like we've just had it. Haven't we just had it? Like, it was already this year, wasn't it? No, it was last year. It was July. I feel like we've already had it. Last week in July, holy dooly. Maybe I'm thinking like Sun in Fun or something. No, got our first air show in over 16 years and making a comeback. Oshkosh is at the end of this month. Ah, roger. Across the lake from you? You mean the air show or Oshkosh? Don't even answer that. I can't believe I'm just... Sometimes I say stupid things. I'm not reading that chat properly. Sorry, just had to turn the fan on. Just getting warm. I had to get my fans replaced in, two fans replaced in summer with this one because it was spinning slow, like super slow. And then I got them replaced, but I spoke to a guy who fixes fans and washing machines and dryers and all that sort of stuff. And what he said... He said, when you turn a fan on, if you want to put it on number 3 so it's going slow, don't turn it on number 3 to start off with. Put it on number 1 and then switch it down to number 3. I'm talking ceiling fans. And he said, the reason for that is because when you put it on number 3, it's not putting enough charge in there, so it stuffs up the motor. And over a period of time, your fans will become slow. So make sure you put it on number 1 and then slow it down. And it looks after the lifespan of the fan. There you go, some interesting useless information depending on what you want to use it for. I think Junior's finally up now. And then I found out after he could have fixed my fans and I didn't need to replace them and spend $700. Go figure. Go figure. Are we landing at the next airport? Yeah, we'll land at the next airport. Visually, I don't know where it is. We're still 23 nautical miles out. it's sort of parallel. Yeah, I don't know if it's on this section here or it's a section or if it's up over there. I might start descending anyway. For the fog, hopefully it will release on Xbox. I believe it's going to release on Xbox, but I'd say with the marketplace at the moment, it probably won't release at the same time due to the backlog that's on the marketplace. So you may have to wait for a little bit after. That's just me assuming, of course. I don't 100% know. It's all dirt strips, no worries. We got 19 nautical miles, so still a fair way off. We are got ground speed of 144. This thing is flying. Look at that. She's zooming across. 144. Hey, Pilot Jax, what's going on?
Are you up, little man? Are you making your brekkie? You're eating it. Come and say hello to the stream. Maybe. I'll pop out after.
As briefed, today's exercise is dogfighting. Guns only, no missiles. We do not go below the hard deck of 5,000 feet. Working as a team, you have to shoot me down or else.
Or else what, sir?
Or else I shoot back.
Alrighty. Where's this strip? I think it's to the right of the Navajo mountain here. Look at that. That's just insane. No worries, Conti. The man, the myth, the legend. You guys in that chat, who actually watches streams over on Twitch as well? Put a one if you watch streams over at Twitch. Or if you just, or two if you just YouTube only. I'm both. Actually, it's just YouTube. Only watch yours? Oh, James. I'm blushing. You say such nice things. Dave does a bit of both. Marcus is only the YouTubes. Gio's only YouTube only. Para Pilot's only YouTube only. Someone's only YouTube only. Ah, that's interesting. YouTube only. That's super interesting. I've never asked that on stream before, but I thought people are just naturally assuming people like me and then just, the YouTuber GOAT, thank you, Kevin. I just assumed, I was tempted to try YouTube stream, but it was too confusing to set up. Oh, mate, you're doing awesome over at Twitch. Nathaniel says, the only stream I watch YouTube, all the rest are on Twitch, I must admit. There we go, thank you very much for letting me know. don't need to go elsewhere. Ah, oh, you guys. I just assume people like me, you just like watching streamers jump between platforms. Kick seems to be coming at more. It just sent your DM on Discord. Thank you, Big Jacko. I'll have a look at it in a second. Yeah, I know. You missed it before, Dave. I was saying before, it's going to be a big week in the world of Microsoft Flight Simulator next week. And I can't really tell. And then I think it was... Was it Mr. Cameron B? He said, oh, someone's doing a seven, a Fokker flight. And I've gone, God damn it! I can't keep a secret. So yeah, so the Fokker's releasing. But you got to stay tuned to the news video. And we will be streaming it when I learn how to fly it. So, but yes. Very much looking forward to it, so... Yeah, I don't think there's not a confirmed date when it's going to release, but they've got an aim for a date. So I'll speak about that in the news because I'll just make sure I read the information I got to make sure it's correct. But with all aims for dates, they you know, if something pops up, it's going to get delayed. But the guys are working super hard to get it out, so. And I'm looking forward to showcasing, and hopefully it's going to be great. So, very excited. I've been hassling our friends at Just Flight for like months. When's the Fokker coming out? Can I get it early? When's the Fokker coming out? Can I get it early? Hey, when's the Fokker coming out? Can I get it early? Like, so many emails. This is the number one plane, or when it comes to airliners, that I'm most excited about is the Fokker. Think it's going to be absolutely amazing. All right, I'm just going to manually fly this because I think I've overflown the airport again. Where's the strip? It's meant to be like 5. I don't even know where it is. So you'll see it. There'll be other There'll be other people that will actually that F-28. The 100 and the 70 are coming out in a different release later on. There it is up here. There'll be other people that'll do a much better job at showcasing it than I will, because they'll probably have more time in it than I will, because I gotta make videos and stuff, so. But yeah. It's gonna be awesome. Would be awesome, yeah. Look at that. That's amazing. Come on, Microsoft Flight Simulator. The sim is amazing. Imagine what it's going to be when we've got stuff like 3D trees and all that sort of stuff. It's going to be crazily good. So we only got 9 knots of wind here at Navajo Mountains because it's getting blocked. So 270 is what we're coming in. So Marcus is going on the right track there. So which one's the road? It turns into a road, isn't it? Is it that one or is it that one? The strip. Okay, so that's the road. That's the strip. Gonna have a crosswind too. Chipper Sneeze coming in. Oh, that's the caribou down there. This is going to be tight, ladies and gentlemen. It'll be a tight turn. Sorry, just smacked the yoke on the microphone. It'll be a tight turn. Brakes on.
Come on, get down. There we go.
There we go. Nice little slip in. That was fun. Love dancing on the rudder pedals. Love dancing on the rudder pedals. No worries, Michael. My pleasure, my friend. Cheers, mate. I'm gonna do a taxi back. Leadville, Colorado. Oh my god, I can't even speak. 9,900. No, altitude's 10,900. Holy dooly. Would struggle that with the Cessna. Alright, we've got one more leg to go. And we're going to do a bit of a tour around Monument and then come in for a retirement of the day. Thank you very much for everybody for coming out and hanging out with us while we did some flying. Having a cup of tea with some homemade chocolate muffin. Oh, nice. It's the highest incorporated town. And there's a dark star. How's the serenity? They give you a certificate. So what's the town altitude? No worries, underdog. See you, mate. There's always one coming in for the air show. Absolutely. Yep. I just don't know. How would you go out of town living somewhere that's like 10,000 foot in altitude? That's crazy. Yeah, 10,000 feet. getting obviously people going up there must suffer from altitude sickness and hypoxia symptoms, I guess. I should be texting with my rudder all the way back. I'm just being lazy. It's a simulator. Get away with it. I am in Switzerland. Geo, mate, you're the man. Thank you very much for staying up late and hanging out with us. We're gonna get straight in the air so we can keep going. Listen to the sound of the Boris. It's nice. Alright, the needle's finally moving. This is going to be crazy, guys. Come on. We're not going to get out in the air. Just wants to fly now. Holy dooly, this is crazy. Fun trying to take off. Did you use flaps for takeoff, Kevin? We did. We had flaps then. Crazy weather. All right, flaps going up. Got a sink. Got a tower over there on the right hand side. Obstacles to avoid as well. Once airborne, you have to know it. Yes, that's correct. It was just actually getting her to take off. Once we hit 50 knots, she wanted to take off, so. But it's good. It's good to simulate that sort of different type of aviation and what did I just press? Pressing wrong things here. To Monument Valley, so we should start seeing the stuff popping up soon. I have no way. I have no way of pronouncing that, but thank you very much. Welcome to the stream. Look at that. Absolutely stunning. You need realistic digital, you need to lean the mixture, yep, by taxiing, yep, absolutely. Need to lean the mixture while taxiing anyway, but a little bit extra more at these conditions. Hey, Mr. Maple Leaf, what's going on? Flying the wrong way. A little bit more, I think. TJ's doing some canyon runs. I can start seeing them up there. Once we get back on course, this will turn itself. There's Mr. Marcus Simmer. Heading, I have no idea, 171. Just wait till we change track in a second. Landing lights are on. Yep, absolutely. There's nothing says that you can't have your landing lights on when you're flying. It's just letting people know where you are. Conservative on the field today. There we go, now it's turning on the track. Absolutely amazing scenery. I thought that we would have a bit more of a sunset being 5:19, but not at this time of the year. There we go. Pretty bumpy, absolutely. We've had gusts on average between 12, gusting up to 29 knots. It's a lot calmer over here than what it was where we took off from Telluride, so a lot more calmer. Once it's close to 8 o'clock, roger. James says, don't bother us. That's insane. 8:33 p.m. local time. Yeah, okay, so there's plenty of daylight left. Oh well, it is what it is. We are flying, whatchamacallit, live time. Excuse me. It's 6:19? Okay, it seems saying 5:19. Insane. Are you doing Marcus? I actually don't. Marcus is probably in VR. Dooley.
Well, yeah, I am indeed.
So you look stunning. Don't look at the marketplace this week, guys. You'll be very, very disappointed. Please still watch tonight's video. Don't look at the marketplace. It's probably one of the worst ones I've seen for a long time. Hang on, why am I still climbing for? This obviously doesn't level off. Nah. I didn't see any. There's a bunch of livery packs, though. Nah. Nah. There's not. The only livery packs... Oh, okay, so the first one's come out. But there's a livery pack in there for the PMDG DC6, which is out. So the DCs, they put that in there ages ago. So hopefully the 737 stuff will start to come behind the scenes now. We might get some 737 liveries, but the DC6 stuff is out. Temps in the high 90s today. There's the monuments. We're going to have a quick cruise around here, then we'll come into the airport, so I'll stay up here high for a little bit. This is the thing I don't understand. I love Microsoft. I love the team over at Microsoft. They give me the opportunity to do this with their great product. But there's one thing I don't understand is when they come and they did the backlog list, and this might be me being ignorant or don't understand or not educated correctly. So I could be saying the wrong information here. But they created the backlog list and then they created priorities 1, 2, 3, and 4. So products that were on priority 1, they would... put those in consideration to be fast-tracked through to get it out to the community because of the demand, right? There's 8 aircraft being in priority 1 and they've been in there for weeks and they're not moving. I don't understand it. Like, how is the priority working? I don't know how it's working. From an outsider in, it doesn't look like it's working. The P1, 2, 3, 4 just looks, doesn't mean anything. It doesn't work. Like, the list, it's not even fluctuating, it's just sitting on 8. I don't understand. One of you guys might have some advice, but I don't understand it. I read the brief of what the outline was, how it works, but it just doesn't look like it's working. They don't seem to be coming out quicker. Maybe the next development update, I might ask the question if I'm awake when they do it and see if they're happy to clarify. India lands? Yeah, I believe so. There's a tile change right on it though. I think I'm using a Orbex monument update, so mine might look a little bit different to you guys. We are cracking it. Look at this, 155 on the ground speed. This thing is like a jet fighter at the moment. Holy dooly, she's moving. He is moving. We're going to do a loop around, then come back in. Westerns film there? Oh yeah, you'd think. It'd be a big tourist place here, wouldn't it? People doing bus tours and all that sort of stuff, I would imagine. I used to have a Monument Airport in P3D, but I don't have one in this one. Everyone's missing the airport? What, this airport here? There's a good freeway for it. Nobody's landing. Yeah, it's because we're having a look around. There's a couple of people already landed down there. Thanks very much, Conti. Appreciate it, mate. Thanks for tuning into the stream. I know you're a busy man and you're having a day off, and I appreciate you spending some time in our stream too. The man, the myth, the legend when it comes to dreaming flight simulation over on Twitch. Number one in Australia. Number one stream in Australia over on Twitch there, in my opinion. Andrew, thank you very much for the subscription. Welcome to the stream. Say I'd do some manual flying, but I need to press the button. This looks like a little tourist little center there. Looks like that's what that looks, what's that look like? So can you actually come out to these things here, or you can't? Like you can't even walk out, or you can? It looks like there's. Oh, there's buildings and stuff out here. That's some shadow that the scenery hasn't taken out. Bit of a shame. And the shadows haven't been taken out. So much altitude. It's going to take ages to get back up to like 7,000 feet. Captain Carl, what's Cessna? We're in the WB Sims Cessna. That's the 172. You can put an exclamation mark just flight in the chat or aircraft and it will pop up the link to where you can go and find it over on their website. Only 10:32 and I'm yawning. Imagine trying to put a double ender or something through the middle of that. That'd be cool. Look at the sink on that. just see that we went down to 1500, just got sucked into the ground. Video keeps dropping. It's looking fine on my end, and I'm not dropping any frames. So, Robin, you might need to just do a refresh on your end, my friend. I'd say it's probably locally to you. Did you see the sink on that, Conti? Holy dooly. We're in dangerous territory now. Driving through that. That'd be insanely crazy. Alright, someone just slewed in. It's so funny when you can see people slewing on the 530. We're gonna make our way back over to the field. I think that's over here somewhere. Bit of coffee left, cold coffee. Living the dream, Robin. Living the dream. Wish I had a spare 430k change to buy a plane, mate. You're living the dream. Congratulations, my friend. Awesome crosswind. Nice. We'll come in behind Mr. Chippy Sneeze. Oh, not you. Okay. Sound like you were saying you got one. I was like, oh, geez, must be nice. 717 fan, see you, mate. And of course, Oz is coming in. Hi. Crossed up. No worries, Kevin. We'll be streaming again tomorrow morning. Maybe we might learn the Fokker tomorrow if I get a chance to learn it, but I probably won't. I've got to make a video, so we shall see. Probably Fokker on Sunday, but... I've got no more rudder. I couldn't put any more left rudder in. That's like one of the worst landings I've done in so long. Holy dooly, that was bad. I'm like, no. I gotta finish the stream. I'm on time constraint this morning. Yeah, no landing fees on that one. That one was free. No, that wasn't a landing. That was a butcher. That was a butcher. Oh, as always, I come in too high with my approaches because I'm too busy watching chats and talking to you lot. And then, yeah, it's just bad flying. I don't have an excuse. I can't blame the weather. I can't blame the plane. I can't blame the sim. That was just me flying crap. very funny. I don't know. I don't even know what I'm doing now. Don't even know what we're doing. Taxi lights. I don't know why I've got the taxi and the landing lights on anyways. A taxi landing at the same time, like a boss. Like a boss. That was fun. The weather made it interesting, as weather does. That's why each flight around when you go flying, even if you fly in the same place, it's always different. If you fly in the same aircraft, same place, because of the weather. Oh, how's the Serenity? Let's just whack a mobile phone reception right here. Let's put it right there in this beautiful place here and just whack it there. But then you would complain if you didn't have reception, wouldn't you? Harrison Ford's land on a taxiway. Is he still flying? Probably not even flying now. What did we work out to be? He's like 85 or something. Oly dolly. Guys, I want to say a big thank you. It was a controlled crash. No, it was a controlled bumpy landing. Oh, yours was worse. Ah. I'm going to say a big thank you to Big Jacko as Gaming for a gifted membership. Daniel, thank you very much for the 5 months in the first class lounge. Tony F for the gifted membership, and also Bide for the Bio for the super chat too. So thank you very much for your support. Special thanks to Just Flight for supporting the streams, and all of you guys, my friends, for coming out and flying with us. I appreciate it. We're going to finish the stream up here. You cheeky bugger. You're the best. Now it's all around the cute people. Sorry, Conti. We will, if you haven't checked it out, we did a video, dropped it last night. Feel free to go over and check that out. Please drop a comment and a like, that's much appreciated. We'll have the news of our video out tonight and we'll be back. I'll put the details up for tomorrow's stream. It will be late tonight by the time I get around to doing that. We will be, yeah. Keep to simming over the weekend, guys. So appreciate it. Much love. Big hugs. Have an awesome start to your weekend. And I'll see you around. standing on the tarmac in the VR next to the Dark Star, looking at Monument Valley. What a bizarre experience. Welcome to Microsoft Flight Simulator. All right, guys. See ya. Cheerio.